As you say.
Thank you. I didn't expect the band's men to notice my escape so quickly. I tried to hide here in the woods, but there wasn't time. And now I'm a dead man. You were there in Ostagar. You know how things went. For me, it was either this, or die in some darkspawn's belly, or be hung as a deserter. You were there with the Grey Wardens. One of Duncan's new recruits. I was to guard the king. He was my friend, understand? Maker. All that time in Ban Loren's prison. And I couldn't stop thinking about all they suffered that one dark night at Ostagar. No, perhaps not. But I've been given the chance to set things right. If it's the likes of you who sees me to my final hour, perhaps things happen for a reason. The king entrusted me with the key to the royal arms chest. If anything were to happen to him, he said, it was vital I deliver it to the Wardens. The Maker has a sense of humor, doesn't he? I suppose it's for the best, however. Had I kept it, it would be in Ban Loren's hands by now.
But you said Kaelin entrusted it to you.
I was afraid. I thought I would lose it on the battlefield, so I stashed it in the camp. Please. It's probably still there. The key's behind a loose stone at the base of a statue. I'll draw a map for you, so you'll know where to search.
It's not a place I thought I'd be returning to so soon, at least of all with you, Grey Warden. If it's not too much to ask of a commanding officer, just keep your moralizing to a minimum.
The events at Ostagar still haunt my thoughts, Warden. If that is where we are headed, I would like to accompany you.
It is vital that the king's documents do not fall into the wrong hands. As for Marek's sword, it is too powerful to be pawed at by those monsters. Same for the king's other arms and armor. And if you happen to find Kaelin's body, see it off. He was our king. He shouldn't be left to rot amidst the Darkspawn's filth.
Let me know when you're done glaring at me, madam. My memories of this place are no fonder than your own.
No. I remember good friends dying in this place, and a man whom I respected as my king.
All I remember is a fool's death and a hard choice. I'd make the same again.
Even knowing all that you know now, Loghain MacTyr?
Even so. Come, madam, our bitterness is better spent against the Darkspawn than each other.
Yes, Maker forbid that I might waste a whole life's bitterness just on you.
Very well.
How cold does the King's metal feel in your hands, Loghain?
I feel nothing, old woman, and your constant prodding for regrets will gain you little.
And what if it had been your daughter in his place? Would you have regrets then?
Had I raised her to be such a fool as that, I'd have been in no better position to save her. What you forget is that your king was beyond saving. The Darkspawn would either have had him or have had us all. Do you really believe we would have been so much better off had I chosen otherwise?
It is my belief that a man who ties his own hands behind his back should not cry foul that there is no one left to defend his king.
It is begun. I shall do it. It is begun.
Oh,
Say when.
Cheating bastard!
Watch your mouth, Loghain MacTyr, unless you have forgotten the company you now keep.
It's not my company I worry about, madam, but my former son-in-law's. Do you see the familiar tone with which the Empress writes him, as if my daughter were not already his wife?
Caelan loved Honora with every ounce of his heart. It was plain for all to see. The only thing that ever stood between them was you.
Are you blind, old woman? The plot is plain as day within this letter. Love or no, Caelan was gonna cast my daughter aside and wed himself to that bitch, Selene. In a single vow, Orlais would claim all that they could never win by war. And what would Ferelden gain? A fool of a king could strut about and call himself an emperor.
And what of peace? Would it not bring us that at least?
Peace. I would have thought your age might have granted more wisdom, madam. Peace just means fighting someone else's enemies in someone else's war for someone else's reasons.
Very well. Very well.
Watch out, trap there.
I shall do it. Very well.
Your wish?
shall do it.
Speak up!
Watch out, trap.
Very well. I shall do it. It shall be done.
Ahead.
Thank you.
still have won the day.
It shall be done. You say. It is begun. It is begun.
Crawling back into their tunnels, are they? Let's take the battle to them!
I shall do it. I'll do it. Very well.
Ah!
ridiculous.
I shall do it.
You've fallen silent, Loghain.
And I wish you would do the same, madam. It's been a long and wearying day.
On that, at least, the two of us can agree.
We are done here. Let's go home and not speak of this again.
Very well.
Speak your venom and get it over with, Loghain.
He may be a fool, but he doesn't deserve to be strung up like this. Sure, throw roses and wax poetic about how great a leader he would have been had he only not thrown himself on the swords of the advancing Darkspawn. As a symbol of the Darkspawn's triumph, don't presume you know so much about me. My preference would be to throw him over the edge to be forgotten. Let him go down in the history books as just another casualty in a long and bloody war. Your wish is my command, Grey Warden. And in this case, your command is also my wish. Let us make it so.